Your online passwords. How safe are they really? What if I told you a hacker could host a perfect custom fake login page, indistinguishable from the real thing, and steal your credentials with ease? Today, we pull back the curtain on this chilling reality. Get ready to see exactly how it's done, and crucially, how to protect yourself. Welcome back, tech enthusiasts and future cyber defenders. Today we're diving into a topic that's both fascinating and a little bit unsettling: how hackers can steal your usernames and passwords using a powerful tool called the Social-Engineer Toolkit, or SEToolkit. What is social engineering? Before we get our hands dirty with the demo, let's understand the core concept, social engineering. It's not about complex code or breaking through firewalls. It's about manipulating human psychology. Hackers exploit our trust, our curiosity, our desire for convenience, to get us to reveal sensitive information or perform actions we wouldn't normally. Think of it as the art of deception. And that's where tools like SEToolkit come in. Developed by trusted SEC, SEToolkit is an open source framework designed for penetration testers to simulate social engineering attacks. It automates many common attack vectors, making it incredibly effective for demonstrating vulnerabilities. Critical disclaimer: this video is for educational purposes only. We're demonstrating these techniques in a controlled, isolated lab environment to show you how they work so you can better protect yourself. Using these tools for malicious purposes without explicit permission is illegal and has severe consequences. Always be ethical. Always be responsible. Our goal here is to empower you with knowledge, not to encourage illegal activity. Today, we'll focus on one of the most common and effective social engineering attacks, credential harvesting. Imagine you receive an email that looks legitimate, maybe from your bank, or a social media site, or even a company you know. This email contains a link. When you click it, you land on a page that looks exactly like the real login page. You enter your username and password, but instead of logging you in, those credentials go straight to the attacker. That's credential harvesting, and SEToolkit can make it surprisingly easy to set up. For this demonstration, I'm using Kali Linux in a virtual machine. SEToolkit comes pre-installed in Kali, or you can easily install it. We'll also need a target machine. In our case, another virtual machine or just a web browser to act as our victim. Live demonstration, SEToolkit credential harvester. All right, let's fire up SEToolkit. First, I'll open my terminal and type sudo SEToolkit to launch the Social Engineer Toolkit. We need root privileges for some of its functions. You'll see the main menu. We want to perform a social engineering attack, so I'll choose option 1. Next, we're dealing with a fake website, so we'll go with website attack vectors, option 2. This is where we tell SEToolkit what kind of attack we want. We're interested in capturing credentials, so credential harvester attack method, option 3, is our choice. We want to clone an existing website to make our fake page look authentic, so site cloner, option 2. SEToolkit will ask for the IP address where it should listen for the stolen credentials. This will be my Kali Linux machine's IP address. I'll enter it here. Now, for the critical step. Which website will we clone? For this practical demonstration, meticulously designed for legal and educational purposes, I'll be using my own Crazy Panda Phishing demo webpage. Anyone looking to practice this demonstration ethically can also utilize this specific demo webpage. Our objective is to illustrate precisely how real-world websites can be mimicked by attackers to steal credentials, making it look as convincingly authentic as possible to expose the deception. As you can see, SEToolkit is now cloning the website and setting up a web server on my machine to host this fake page. It's listening on port 80 for any incoming connections and, more importantly, for any credentials entered. Now let's put ourselves in the shoes of the victim. Imagine they've just received that malicious email we talked about. They click the link, and it takes them to this page. See? It looks identical to the real site. The victim has no reason to suspect anything. They'll probably just think they were logged out or need to re-authenticate. So the victim innocently types in their username. Let's say testusser@example.com and a password, MySecretPass123. They hit Login. The page might even redirect them to the actual login page of the service, making them think they just made a typo, or perhaps didn't even notice the redirection. They might try again on the real site, none the wiser that their credentials have just been compromised. And now, for the chilling part. Let's go back to our attacker machine, our Kali terminal, where SEToolkit is running. Boom, right there. The username and password entered by the victim have been captured and displayed in plain text. This is how easily a hacker, with just a bit of social engineering, can obtain sensitive information. What if your target isn't on your local network? What if they're across the city, or even across the world? This is where Ngrok becomes incredibly useful. Ngrok creates a secure, public tunnel to your local web server, allowing anyone on the internet to access it. Even if you're behind a router or firewall, getting AnyWalk ready is surprisingly simple. First, you'll need to create a free account on the AnyWalk website, anywalkray.com. This is essential to get your auth token. Once you have an account, open a terminal in Kali and install Ngrok. Sudo apt install Ngrok. After installation, you need to connect your Ngrok client to your account. You'll find your unique auth token on your Ngrok dashboard. Run this command, replacing your underscore auth underscore token with your actual token. Ngrok config add auth token, your underscore auth underscore token. Now with SEToolkit's web server still running on our Kali machine, typically on port 80 as we saw before, we'll open a new terminal window. We'll tell Ngrok to create a public tunnel to that local port. The command to expose our local web server, which SEToolkit is running, to the internet is work http://localhost port 80. Ngrok gives us a public HTTPS link, something like https://random-subdomain.ngrok-free.app/. This is the link you'd send to your target anywhere in the world. Now, an Ngrok URL like random-subdomain.ngrokfree.app can still look suspicious. To make your link even more persuasive and realistic, attackers often use URL masking. If you have a custom domain with Ngrok, which usually requires a paid plan, this lets you use your own more convincing domain name. Now, imagine our victim, miles away, clicks that Ngrok link. The page loads flawlessly. They might not even notice the ngrokfree.app domain. Or even better, if you've used URL masking, they'll see your custom, highly persuasive domain. They type their username and password, perhaps alice@company.com, and a common password. They hit login. The data travels through Ngrok's tunnel, right back to our Kali machine. And just like that, bam! The credentials appear right here in our SEToolkit terminal. Username and password, captured in plain text from a target anywhere on the internet. This is the power and danger of combining social engineering with global tunneling. How to protect yourself, crucial takeaways. So, how do we protect ourselves from such attacks? It boils down to vigilance and critical thinking. Always check the URL. Before entering any credentials, always look at the URL in your browser's address bar. Is it the correct domain? Is there a padlock icon for HTTPS? Hackers often use subtle misspellings, typo squatting, or strange subdomains. Be suspicious of unexpected links. If you receive an email with a link, especially if it's unexpected or asking for urgent action, be wary. Don't click it directly. Instead, open your browser and navigate to the legitimate website manually. Enable two-factor authentication, 2FA-MFA. This is your strongest defense. Even if a hacker gets your password, 2FA means they'll still need a second verification, like a code from your phone, to access your account. Keep software updated. While social engineering targets humans, having up-to-date browsers and operating systems can sometimes help mitigate certain attack vectors. The digital world is full of amazing opportunities, but it also has its dark corners. Social engineering, especially through tools like SEToolkit, highlights the importance of being aware and vigilant. It's often the weakest link, the human element, that gets exploited. By understanding these techniques, you become a stronger human firewall and help protect not just yourself, but also those around you. If you found this demonstration insightful, please hit that like button, subscribe for more cybersecurity content, and share this video to help others stay safe online. What other ethical hacking tools would you like to see demonstrated? Let me know in the comments below. Stay curious, stay secure, and I'll see you in the next video.